Day 98. Today, Maimonides discusses unkosher meats that we cannot eat. So number one, he discusses the meat. If you find an animal that was attacked in your field, that was not necessarily killed, still alive, but it was attacked, you cannot eat from this animal, and you can't even get any benefit from its meat. Number two, you cannot eat a portion, a limb of the body of an animal. And this goes for non-Jewish people as well. You know, in addition to the 613 of the Torah laws, there are also seven Noahide laws given to non-Jewish people. And this is one of them, that you cannot eat a limb of an animal. We cannot eat the sciatic nerve from an animal. And this comes back to the story of Jacob, when Jacob was attacked by the angel of Esau, and he was hurt in the sciatic nerve. And to this day, in memory of that, we do not eat that part. Although a very skilled butcher can somehow remove that nerve so that we can still eat that meat, it's seldom done today. It's usually the hind parts of the animal is usually cut out and sold to the non-kosher eateries. Eating blood is forbidden, and I always find this one fascinating because for so many years there were these terrible blood libels against the Jewish people, and you know how they would say that Jewish people needed blood of Christian boys, God forbid, to put into their matzah for Passover. And blood libels were a huge, huge part of our history. And it's so ironic because blood is not kosher. We cannot have blood. We can't have animal blood, never mind human blood, is forbidden from the Torah. So it really never made any sense. And then finally, there are forbidden fats on an animal that are not allowed as well. And I just wanted to go back to that first part where we spoke about the limbs and you know, the first part that we spoke about, the treif meat, that if you find the animal in the field and not being able to eat that and having a piece of the limb. And I just wanted to point out that the purpose of these laws was really because of trying to avoid cruelty to animals. That back in the day, they didn't have refrigerators like we do, and it was cheaper and made more sense to just cut off limb by limb and eat it that way. And that way the animal didn't go bad and it lasted for longer. And obviously this is terrible cruelty to animals. And because we want to avoid that, and because we are compassionate people, again, it is not only for Jewish people, it's for non-Jewish people as well. And it just goes to show the compassion and the care that the Torah gives to animals. And you know, obviously this goes for every type of cruelty to animals. Now, we do eat animals, we do eat them, and that's because our slaughtering process is very special and done in a way that is humane and done in a way that the animal suffers the least amount of pain. However, cruelty to animals is something that we are very, very sensitive to, and we are very careful not to just kill an animal for no reason. And just in general, the treatment of animals is an important part of our culture. And so I think that's something interesting that I'm not sure if that's known about. But if we're so careful with how we treat animals, I would just add that little point of, let's be even more careful with how we treat people, especially people we love, especially the people around us. And remember that every single person you encounter is a soul of God that needs your love, that needs your affection, and is waiting for your smile. Have a great day.